How's it going, guys? Chris back here again with some more Historic Brawl. Last time around we checked out a fairly aggressive Walls deck. This time around, we're going Mill. Mill got some really cool toys in the Brothers War. Mainly in the Retro Artifact slots, but still got some really cool toys. We're going to play around with some of them. So we got Mesmeric Orb and Kinning Stone. Those were the two main additions. There were other things too. Like technically Takasa, but she's kind of self-mill, right? Because of Surveil. This is actually really good. Mesmeric Orb is sneakily powerful. I think I'm going to go into Diligent Excavator first, though. Some of you may recognize Diligent Excavator from Kathith combos. He's really popular in Kathith combos. I guess she is. Because you cast your zero mana artifact, you mill two cards, which is required by Kathith to recast your zero mana artifact. So I bet they play a 3-drop here. That's like a Battle Mech Golem. Yeah, there's a 3-drop. We're gonna take 3 damage. We can afford it. A opponent. Have you ever heard of Mesmeric Orb? So this is still a little bad because we can only block one creature this turn. If they haste up their commander, we still only get one block, right? Because the commander goes from 3 power to 4. So blocking would kill our creature. If they just haste up the Reckless Stormcaller, we can block with our Merfolk, right? I guess we can go like this and refuse the card draw. Sad. No block. Yeah, so this deck is not going to be fast to get it through matchups, right? Because if it wins, it takes a while to win. Are they going to try to mill me? Oh, protection from blue. Draw your card, opponent. I'm still winning the mill race. Because Bruvac is powerful. And you're drawing cards, which is not good. We're gonna get, I don't even know if we're gonna get close. We might get halfway there. But we're really in bad shape. Because this 6 damage a turn will kill us. and gets rid of our orb. So we block here, we block here. We're not dead. But we might as well be. The werewolf deck has nearly milled as many cards as we have. So, like, Kenning Stone off the top wins the game. Aha. That's unfortunate. Unfortunate. We'll go on to game two. We will mill somebody, hopefully. We have more chances. The game is not up. But I spent a couple hours yesterday just trying to run around and get to as many of the smithing bell bearings in Elden Ring as possible. And then I realized that on my first character, I literally had achieved having all of the bell bearings. And I don't know if, I don't think they cover continue from New Game Plus, so I actually do think I need to catch them again, don't I? So maybe it was a worthwhile endeavor. I was worried that it might not have been. Wow. So we have dodged the sensor. If they cast something, we know what's up, but they didn't. Yeah, we know one damage a turn isn't gonna do it. So I'm guessing it's mana leak, basically. Also weirdly Russian.
I am the master of the dead here.
Yeah, we'll cast it. Oh, we've stopped the beats. Maybe. Are they gonna tap the gargoyle? If they tap the gargoyle, they mill two, we mill one. That's good for us. they're willing to sacrifice two creatures to kill Bivouac. Or Bruvac. He has a real name. Arcane Mastery for 3. Spell Pierce. Nope. Okay. Ooh, excuse me. So we mill 12 cards? We're getting there. Yeah, and there's no point in attacking with him. Yeah, the mill's still happening, right? Down to 50 cards. I feel like Oshintai is less likely to hit a removal spell, but if we can play both, we should, right? Bruvac's gonna eat another removal spell. Proliferate, okay. The creatures in my deck are really bad. So. I'm kind of okay with them dying. And one good draw. Like, we suddenly enter the game again. So they're gonna get the best three creatures in my deck. Which there aren't any, so... Do they gain haste too? I forgot about Jinkataxius. He is a good creature in my deck. I lied. So we have to block here. And I think we can take 5. So we need to mill 32. Which seems insane, honestly. And now they probably have a removal spell. So this mill's 8. Don't really got anything else to do. So this mill's 8. minus mill, 6. This mill's 1. So we got him down to 6 cards in library. That's unfortunate. Jinkataxia said upkeep. We would have won. But it's instep. GG. We got very close. I'd say there are probably mill lines that I have just not learned yet. And when we get stronger, we'll know how it's done. I'd say one of the... I don't want to say one of the first, but one of, like... the early mythics I opened up in my career playing Magic was a Phoenix. And Phoenix is the blue-black god from Theros. And his ability is basically creatures you control have tap, add, tap target player mills equal to their, equal to the creature's toughness. We're up against a Lazav deck. Lazav is a very cool commander. I very much like him. A reconnaissance mission is not going to be doing great, but we can cycle it. I was going to say filter, but filter is not a mechanic. I do know Magic mechanics. I have played long enough to understand that there are words on the card that say what they do. Start mill an opponent. I'm gonna draw a card too, because, you know. No attack. So Bivouac down with Psychic Corrosion down with a Magic Mirror. Probably gonna win the game very quickly. It's getting there that's the issue against the blue-black deck, right? So I didn't anticipate getting to cast Psychic Corrosion this turn. But I am going to. Nope. Because Teferi's Tutelage or Psychic Corrosion with Biv Bruvac out is just insane. Funny enough story, I was talking about Magic Duels the other day, the older Arena client. Psychic Corrosion was one of the decks on there for one of those storyline paths for Magic Origins. You fought as Jace against somebody with a Psychic Corrosion deck, and it was really, really cool. I built it and played it with Twin-Headed Dragon a bunch. That was our game 3. We technically won. But I'm gonna do one more game. Like, our last video was like 12 minutes. Our last Magic video, anyways. That to say, the Elden Ring ones have set times, so they don't really change much. we will keep. But I'm thawing some chicken, so hopefully that will be thawed by the time I finish up this recording session. Hey, opponent, you have plants. Ooh, they're a Ramos deck. I can appreciate that. Ramos is kind of cool. Ornithopter Paradise? We went with the Ornithopter over our commander because we want to flip the dagger, right? And the Ornithopter has flying, so it can probably flip the dagger. So next turn, we are mana neutral, right? Because we equip this. We swing it like this. Transform this. Play our Bruvac. We have good times. The mono blue deck has outramped the Ramos deck. Very sad. Uh-huh. Do I dare? I think I'm gonna play the Gales. Wow, those were some bad draws. The Ramos deck is just drawing up a storm. So next turn we can draw five cards with Seagate Restoration. Which does not feel worse, honestly. We also have to start dealing damage. Because our mill plan is not working. Go, go, Gale. And then Unspeakable. Yeah, fair enough. Root. Take action. Bottom, bottom. Draw an extra card every turn. And then we'll actually play the Restoration as a land. Bruvac. Pass the turn. We gotta build up our cards. The Ramos deck is doing weird things, and I'm not sure I'm okay with it. So what I thought Ramos does is that he builds up counters, and then... Card. Nadir Kraken. Land. Pass the turn. Okay, I feel like I might have lost. Oi. Root. We'll deal with it later. Pay one. Mill four. Goodbye, Orrery. I love Chromatic Orrery, but I don't love it in other people's decks. Like, it's pure filth in other people's decks. They are really testing it. I think I can wait a little bit longer. Go ahead and mill 20 cards. And yeah, I'll pop down a Panharmonicon. You know, just in case. Forgot the other four cards you have to mill. I really hope they don't have a Mizzix Mastery. Like, if we mill 60 cards in their deck and they Mizzix Mastery, hey, it's rude. Imareth? That was something I was worried about, honestly. That we use our Wrath and then Eerie Ultimatum. I guess I was talking about Mizzix Mastery, right? But, like, this is equally bad, if not worse. Oh god, this is gonna be such a terrible board state. I do get my hand back. It's kind of nice. They went conservative, though, I think. No, they did not. They took everything. This is just a bunch of smut. They have just a casual 9 mana left. So drawing two cards doesn't do much for him. Yeah, I guess Imareth is probably the best thing going. Casual 8 mana left. Ooh, forgot to count this row. So there is a weird situation where we win, right? There's gotta be. But they really don't like graveyards. This is the kind of deck that I want to run into when I'm running a mean deck like Brawl. Yeah, sure, I'll pay. Don't really have any reason not to. Mill two. Yeah, I'm gonna GG. This is getting a little too laggy. But I like seeing ankle bolus on the board. Either way, thank you guys so much for watching. If you did enjoy, remember to leave a like, subscribe to the channel, and I will see you next time. Bye for now.